Brothers and sisters, I can't be more proud of you in the way you pass those resolutions. Now we have a chance to remind ourselves of the importance and power of work to touch lives of working people. I have had the privilege to welcome some of our immigrant brothers and sisters up here to the stage to be with me today. I would like you to meet some of the union members. These are union members who have recently become citizens due to the effort of their union, their labor councils, and their communities. Please help me work.
María Pedro Francisco. Ella es mi nieto.
Hi, my name is Juana Gaspar, and my grandmother, also known as everybody's mama in Alabama, and she has been working in the United States for 22 years, and she has become a U.S. citizen in July 2016 with the help of our union, UFCW.
Here is our certificate.
Good afternoon. My name is Beatriz Cepeda. I was born in El Salvador. I have been working in the United States for 20 years at Gordon JBS in Marshalltown, Iowa. I became a citizen with the help for my union, UFCW.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Adalgisa Ortiz. I came from the Dominican Republic. I have been working in the United States for 8 years. I'm working JBS in Reading, Pennsylvania. I become a citizen with the help of my union, the UFCW.
Hi, my name is Skender Abazaga. I was born in Kosovo. I have worked for United States for 17 years as daily manager. I have it for this country. I became citizens in this country with help from my union, UFCW, Local 338, New York. Thank you, UFCW. Thank you for help for me and my family. Thank you very much.
So who's next?
I hereby declare on oath that I swear to renounce and abjure absolutely and entirely all allegiance and fidelity to any foreign prince, potentate, state, or sovereignty of whom or which I was before a subject or citizen.
So what she told you is some of you who have not done this don't know this. I have done it. When you become a U.S. citizen, you have to do the oaths, and that was the first part of the oaths. So what we're going to do as immigrants is we're going to teach you what the oaths that we commit to this country to.
I I swear to support and defend the Constitution. I lost the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
I swear to bring true faith and allegiance to the same and to bear arms on behalf of the United States when required by the law.
And finally,
I swear to perform non-combat service in the armed forces of the United States when required by the law, or perform work of national importance under civilian direction when required by their law, and that I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purposes of evasion. Thank you.
So help me God. Brothers and sisters, this oath compels us to take action when we become citizens of this great country. We can stand up for our rights at work without fear. We can vote for our candidate who will fight for our issues, for working people. With this resolution just passed, we have committed ourselves to continue to help more working people, naturalized citizens, but it doesn't happen easily. It requires all of you to be part of it, because there are 9 million people who can join us at the ballot box tomorrow if we can help them. This is vitally important, empowering for work for our labor movement. But we also need to remember, we really need to remember, we still have 11 million men and women in our country for an average of 13 years who have lived here, who would like nothing more than to be on stage like these people and tell you they love the United States of America, because they do. And that is the fight for our movement as we move forward. Pass to citizenship, pass to citizenship. That is the standard we'll always hold, and we'll stand up for every single one of them. Brothers and sisters, that is the American DNA. The immigrant DNA is our DNA. Anybody who wants to mess up with that DNA is messing up with all of us. We are talking about hardworking people like my brother Hugo, who's a member of the Painters Union, who got arrested for merely showing up to work. He can't be here with us today or be with his family because he has been detained for the last 6 months just for showing up to work. We are also talking about our brothers and sisters with DACA and TPS who have been working in our country legally for years and who are now at risk of having their status and work permits cruelly stripped away from them. These are people who work with us every day, and I want you to meet them. TPS and DACA recipients, please come on, come here and tell us who you are.
Thank you, brothers and sisters. Good afternoon. My name is Marvin Munch. I have been working in the United States for the last 20 years as a bricklayer and a proud worker under the temporary protection status. I'm also a father of 3 beautiful children that have enjoyed the benefits of their father being a union member. Not just a union member, but a proud organizer for the International Union of Bricklayers and Allied Craft Workers. But under the current administration, I might lose my work authorization. I might lose my driving privileges. Basically, I might lose my freedom. After 20 years, I'm not moving forward. In fact, I might go backward. What that means, I might become illegal, might become undocumented again. And I might have to go back to the shadows. Personally, there's something that I want everybody here to know. There's people out there, people like me, that truly appreciate what unions have done in the past, what unions are currently doing, and what unions will be doing tomorrow to help workers, regardless of their skin color, what language they speak, what accent they got, their gender. I want you to know that. So please understand that. And I want to thank you for your support on this resolution. Thanks.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. My name is Erika Lopez. I'm from El Salvador. I came in here 17 years ago with my two children, 2 and 5 years old. I worked very hard, 14 years. I worked in the laundries, and now I working for Culinaria Union 226 Las Vegas. I'm very proud because I member the Culinaria Union and unite here. And I blessed and thankful because my union support me and thousands of workers the same me in Las Vegas. Almost 7,000 workers in casinos and laundry. When this government saw that we need to come back at our country, I feel worried and scared for my family, my children, and thousands, this is my situation. My home for 17 years is Las Vegas, and my children too. And I know one come back at the shadow. That's it, that we need the support, the old union, support the everyone, the toll, the old history, because it's me, the same thousand peoples. That's the, I say thank you everybody for your time. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon. My name is Karen Reyes, and I was born in Mexico. I have been in the United States since I was 2 years old, since 1991. And I have been protected under DACA for the last 5 years. And I have been working as a special education teacher in Austin, Texas for the last 4. I am a proud member of Education Austin, an affiliate of the AFT right there. But without your help and without your commitment to help pass the Clean Dream Act, I may lose my work authorization card in August. My students will lose their teacher, and I will go back in the shadows, fearful and losing the voice that my union helped me find. Without your help and your commitment in this fight, thousands upon thousands of your union brothers and sisters will be at risk. And I want nothing more than to be able to say that pledge. And I know with your help, I can, because you won't let anything happen to me or my other union brothers and sisters. Sí se puede. Sí se puede.
Bonsoir. Non, moi c'est Marie Parfait. Moi sorti Haïti. Moi ap travay pour 15 ans dans pays aux États-Unis. Moi travay di swa chè. Moi ap travay en bas yon TPS. Moi son même union. M'a demandé pour union aider moi pour me gagner TPS moi l'autre année si Dieu veut pour me capable de travailler parce que si me perds du travail là moi pas travailler moi pas ca utile tête moi rien moi pas ca aider tête moi moi c'est une maman qui gagne 5 petites et moi gagne 12 petites à petites moi capable prêter dans pays à forme travail pour m'aider tête moi. Moi demande pour union capable aider moi pour toujours aider moi l'autre année si Dieu veut pour me capable gagner travail moi toujours pour me travailler. Merci.
Good afternoon. My name is Marie Parfait. I was born in Haiti. I've been working in United States for 15 years as a dishwasher under TPS. And I'm a proud member of Unite Here, Local 355 in Miami. Without your help, I may lose my authorization to work. It will impact me and my family of 5 kids and 12 grandchildren. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mary Kate. I was born in Mexico, Michoacán. When I was 5, my grandma told me I was going to the United States to eat cheeseburgers. But who would have thought that I would be eating cheeseburgers till I was 22? I've been working at Rouse for 5 years with my DACA. And I'm a proud member of Union UFCW. Without your help, I will lose my work permit and I won't be eating cheeseburgers no more.
Hi, my name is Frances Garcia. I am from San Pedro Sula, Honduras. I'm working on the United States for more than 21 years. And 10 of those years I've been working as a guest room attendant. I'm very proud to be part of the United Here and the Culinary Union 226 Las Vegas. I'm working over here under the TPS for so many years, and it's very scary to feel that you're going back not only under the shadow, but far away from your kids. I have 3 kids who were here in Arizona, and I don't want to be separate from my kids. I'm very thankful to be here, and I'm very glad to know the union here and Culinary is supporting us. Thank you.
Brothers and sisters, we're also talking about our Muslim brothers and sisters whose ability to travel and spend time with their family is uncertain because racists in the White House decided to discriminate against them, and because of the travel ban. That would have denied entry to America when I was fleeing my country because the Sudan was part of that list. Brothers and sisters, please help me welcome and meet my brother, Arash, from Washington State, to tell us his story. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. Honestly, as an Iranian person, I cannot start the speech before making sure you're doing great. So how are you? Thank you. My name is Arash. I was born in Iran. I have been working in the United States for about 5 years as a research assistant, as a PhD student. I'm an elected bargaining committee member in the UAW, and I have been an officer in my union for more than 4 years. My union, the UAW, has been using my story to help fight for justice. I'm honestly, wherever I go, I feel that place is like my country, and people are part of my family as well. I'm from a family of farmers, and I used to see my family to work very hard, very hard. But we were very happy at the end, at the harvest time. I feel the same thing here. Here is like my country, and you are like part of my family. I think we need to do the same thing now. We need to work hard against the travel ban to get the harvest, to get the diversity here. Discrimination has no place in the United States, in this country. And nobody understands that better than our labor movement. Again, thank you so much for being here today, and I wish a great evening for all of you. Thank you.
Brothers and sisters, just please take a look at these people on stage. This is not an extra work. This is a work of your membership because they happen to be those main paying members of our unions. This is our job. Above all, I feel it deep in my heart, in my bones, in every fiber in me. This country is better off because you're in it. Our unions are better off because you're a member of it. Texas is going to be better off because Montserrat is going to lead in it. Our country is better off because of the Muslims, the Christian, the Hindu, and those who don't practice religion. This is why I came to this country for, brothers and sisters. This is a cause worth fighting for. This is a cause putting our resources for. This is worth it. This is our job, brothers and sisters. We will not back down. We will not back down from this job. Not one inch, not this movement, not the labor movement. In the land of the free and the home of the brave, everyone deserves a right to be protected at the workplace. We will hold that line and fight for dignity for every worker, everywhere. It doesn't matter where you are born, what language you speak, what kind of an accent you have. This is our fight because this is our family and because this is a country for all of us, brothers and sisters, and those of you on the stage. You are as an American as Donald Trump is. Never, ever give that up. Do you agree with me? We don't leave no worker behind. We don't leave no worker behind.